Good morning. Good morning, everyone. Time to praise the Lord. Jesus coming. Time to praise the Lord. Check your phones. Jesus, the light of the world, 5:14 in your hymn books. Let's sing two verses, first two verses. Jesus, the light of the world. So let's hear your voices. Part 3, 5:14. Jesus, the light of the world. Hark the herald angels sing, Jesus, the light of the world. Glory to the newborn King, Jesus, the light of the world. We will walk in the light, a beautiful light, and come where the dewdrop mercy are bright, shine all around us by day and by night, Jesus, the light of the world. Joyful all ye nations rise, Jesus, the light of the world. Join the triumph of the sky, Jesus, the light of the world. We will walk in the light, the beautiful light, the come where the dewdrops of mercy shall bright, shine all around us by day and by night, Jesus, the light of the world. We walk in the light, a beautiful light, come where dewdrops of mercy are bright, shine all around us by day and by night, Jesus, the light of the world. Amen. Is the reason for the season. Reading this morning will come out of Luke. Luke 1. We're going to read verses 26 through 33. So Luke 1, 26. We'll do a responsive reading. I'll start out on 26 and we'll all end up on 33 together. Amen? Amen. All right.
Hold up.
I'm waiting. Yeah. Luke 1:26. That's the start.
Amen.
And we'll end up at 33. 26 reads, "And in the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent from God into a city of Galilee named Nazareth,
to a virgin betrothed to a man whose name was Joseph of the house of David.
And the angel came in unto her and said, Hail, thou art highly favored, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women.
And when she saw him, she was troubled at his saying, and cast in her mind what manner of salvation this should be.
And the angel said unto her, Fear not, Mary, for thou hast found favor with God.
And behold, thou shalt conceive in thy womb, and bring forth a son, and shall call his name Jesus.
He shall be great, and shall be called the Son of the Highest, and the Lord God shall give unto him the throne of his father David, and together and he shall reign over the house of Jacob forever, and his kingdom there shall be no end. So we have read Luke 1, verses 26 through 33. May the Lord have the blessing to the reading, hear, and do it of his holy word.
Just thanking you in so many ways. We ask you right now to bless the sick and afflicted wherever they might be, Father.
Yes, yes.
We know you're already there, Father. But you told us to ask, Father. We ask that you touch them wherever they might be, at home, hospital, nursing home, or even here this morning, Father. Touch right now, Father.
Touch
the family this morning, Father. Whatever they are dealing with, we know sometimes the doctors didn't tell the family there ain't nothing else that they can do, but you have the last say so, Father.
Yes,
the doctor treat and you does the healing, Father.
Yes,
and we know that you are still in the healing business right now, Father. Touch and heal this morning,
touch,
Father.
Touch, Lord, touch.
In the name of Jesus this morning, just touch right now, Father.
Amen. Yes, yes.
Father God, we just ask this morning that you bless someone that may be here on the way, may not be here, but just on the way to the church somewhere, even at home, that don't know you're in the free part of their sin. Touch right now, Father.
Touch, Lord, touch.
Touch right now, Father, that they hear the word, they seek your word, and they come running and ask them, what must I do to be saved?
Yeah.
And we'll just give you all the praise and all the honor, Father. Father God, we love you.
Yes.
We praise you. We thank you for all that you have done. You bless so many of us this morning, Father. You bless our sister, Anna Ruth. She came through, Father, and graduated. And just keep on blessing us, Father, because every time we turn around here at Mount Olive, we find that you're still blessing us, Father.
Thank you.
So many of us have been blessed in the year of 2019, Father. And we just want to give you praise. We just want to thank you for your blessing this morning. Father God, we just love you once again, Father.
Love you, Lord.
For all that you have done for us.
Amen.
We want to praise you and lift you up right
now.
Amen. In your son Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
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 Come and go to that land. Come and go to that land.
Peace and happiness in that land.
nothing but joy.
level to the ground. Please give me, Lord, a clean heart that I might follow thee.
All right.
But give me, Lord, a clean heart and I might follow thee.
morning.
Good morning.
A special note of thanks, straight from our heart. This is from the choir usher. We'd like to thank everyone for their help with the Christmas dinner. Thank you very much.
Amen.
This afternoon, we'll have our Christmas program at 4 o'clock. We hope everyone will return.
Amen.
On the 31st, we will have night watch at 10 o'clock. And do we have any visitors? That's all I have. I'll turn it over to the pastor. Thank you.
Amen. Amen.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Merry Christmas, everybody.
Amen. Merry Christmas to you, sir.
And blessed day as we recognize this time of year what the real reason for the season is.
Amen.
Right.
Amen. Just want to encourage all of you to return this afternoon at 4 for our Christmas musical program that we'll be having. And then also New Year's Eve service. Have a new young pastor. He just got called to the church. His first Sunday won't be until first Sunday of January, but he's going to be with us on New Year's Eve night. And we've invited his new church. I'm not sure if they're going to come because he's doing an earlier service with them, so he can be here with us that night. But they may come in a couple other churches as well. So let us again be here to see out 2018 and see in 2019. And I don't know about you, but I can't wait to see 18 get on its way. Yeah, man, it's been quite a year.
Yes.
Trying, but that's part of life.
Yes.
But I have on the calendar at home, goodbye 2018. Hello 2019. Yeah, man. So let us come. And again, there's no better place to be than the house of the Lord.
Amen.
Amen.
Man. Amen. Here. No, they're going to be here in the Lord's house. Amen. Amen. God bless you.
That's right.
To be a Christian in my
Now it's time for our tithes and offerings.
Praise the Lord!
With Brother Family is standing for our tithes and our offerings. Benevolence, it's been a while. And I just for fun. Remember to say that for Brother Harry, he's right to stand for our pastoral support. Remember,
yes.
The pastor is taken care of through the church. But we need to take care of our soul. Amen. So, let me pray for this. Turn to Father, this one. Thank you now, Lord. What you've done for us. Thank you for Jesus that paid it all. So Lord, we ask your blessings upon this offering. Bless those that had to give, those that had desire, and not the means. May this offering be used for the uplifting of your holy kingdom. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
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 Now the birth of Jesus was on this wise. When asked his mother Mary was his spouse Joseph, before they came together, she was found with child of the Holy Ghost. Then Joseph, her husband, being a just man and not willing to make her a public example, was minded to put her away privately. But while he thought on these things, behold, the angel of the Lord appeared unto him in a dream, saying, Joseph, thou son of David, fear not to take unto thee Mary thy wife, for that which is conceived in her is of the Holy Ghost. And she shall bring forth a son, and thou shalt call his name Jesus. For he shall save his people from their sin. Now all this was done that it might be fulfilled which was spoken of the Lord by the prophet, saying, behold, a virgin shall be with child, and shall bring forth a son, and they shall call his name Emmanuel, which being interpreted is God with us. Then Joseph, being raised from sleep, did as the angel of the Lord had bidden, and took unto him his wife, and knew her not till she had brought forth her firstborn son, and they called his name Jesus. Make a joyful noise.
Make it.
Unto the Lord, all ye land. Serve the Lord with gladness. Come before his presence with singing. Know ye that the Lord is God. It is he that hath made us.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
And not we ourselves.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
We are his people.
Yes.
And the sheep of his pasture. Enter into his gates with thanksgiving, and into his courts with praise. Be thankful unto him, and bless his name. For the Lord is good. For the Lord is good. His mercy is everlasting, and his truth endureth to all generations. Praise. Praise ye the Lord. Praise God in his sanctuary. Praise him in the firmament of his power. Praise him for his mighty acts. Praise him according to his excellent greatness. Praise him with the sound of the trumpet. Praise him with the psaltery and harp. Praise him with the timbrel and dance. Praise him with the stringed instruments and organs. Praise him upon the loud cymbal. Praise him upon the high sounding cymbal.
Yep.
Let everything,
everything
that has breath,
yep,
let everything,
yep,
that has breath,
yep,
praise ye the Lord.
Church, say amen.
Amen.
It's prayer time as you come to the altar. You know, it's one thing to go through 2018 by yourself, but when you got the Lord on your side, the word says, if it had not been for the Lord on our side, where would I be? And I thank God that I can go into 2019 with the Lord. And my prayer is today of somebody that don't know the Lord today, after the preached word, or even before the preached word, give your life to Christ. Because that's what matters. For what you do for Christ will last. Continue to pray one for another. The one sitting behind you, in front of you, and on the side of you.
Yes, sir.
Even pray for yourself. God answers prayer. He's still in the prayer blessing business. And you know what? You can call him up anytime you get ready. And what I like about it, he won't put you on hold.
Yes.
You ain't got to be worried about being transferred to 9 or 10 people. For he said, come boldly to the throne of grace. Oh, yeah, that's what I like about him, because he's a on-time, right now God. Continue to pray for those that are in bereavement, and pray for our pastor and his wife, and just pray. Because we pray for the young gentleman that died this past week, for the schools, and so just pray. We need prayer.
Amen.
Shall we bow our heads? Lord, we come now, not for no show, shape, form, fashion.
Well, Lord.
But we come, Lord, realizing and acknowledging that if it had not been for you on our side, where would we be?
Well, yes, Lord.
We thank you, Lord, because you are God. Besides, you are God all by yourself. Thank you, Lord, because you're Alpha and Omega. You're the beginning and the end. You're the first and the last. We thank you, Lord, because you are grace and mercy. We thank you for all that you have done, what you will do, what you're going to do. We just want to thank you, Lord, because you have been better to us than we have our own self. And we just want to say thank you for looking down on us and protecting us from danger, seen and unseen. We just want to say thank you, Lord. We come to the house of worship, Lord, because we want to give you the praise and the glory, Lord. We ask that you touch those that are standing at the altar. Whatever their prayer request may be, Lord, we ask that you grant in your own time. We know your yes is good as your no is good as your yes, and sometimes you might have to wait, but Lord, we know that you answer all prayer. And not only that, Lord, maybe somebody in the congregation this morning that don't know your son Jesus, that